It was the week everyone was waiting for, especially Jabba's son Oscar.
Yep.
The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1 was released in cinemas this Thursday, immediately topping the box office with the largest opening day of any movie this year.
Now, the series finale has been split into two parts, something fans are divided over. And for the first time, the Hunger Games themselves make no appearance. Our movie man, Jason Jabba Davis, volunteered as tribute to see this film. He joins us now. It's going to be huge. Yeah. Everyone's going to go, you know, everyone's going to go and see it. Does it stack up?
Look, they call these franchises the Hunger Games franchise. This is the third film, critic-proof. So it doesn't really matter why anyone says.
Yep.
You know, crowds flock to see movies like this. Not just Oscar excited this week. Quinn as well, he's going to see it this afternoon. Ruby, probably a few years off from seeing this. I do wonder about parents taking their kids to see films like this. Very dark. Mm. Some of the commentary about this film is, you know, a kid's going to see it and go, oh, is this what's happening in Syria, Mummy?
Yeah. Right.
You know, it's very much about a rebellion that's happening against the capital, against corporate greed, about the environment being destroyed. Katniss Everdeen, of course, Jennifer Lawrence, is reprising her role. She has become the face of the rebellion now after being rescued from the Hunger Games. She is taking on board the role of the Mockingjay, which is a bit of a Che Guevara, Joan of Arc type of poster girl for the rebellion. It's a really grim film. It reminded me of a really good Midnight Oil album. It's political, it's entertaining, it's riveting, it's catchy, and it's grim.
Wow. Mm.
Really worth
it's
seeing.
Good.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I mean, some of the fans, as you're saying before, they're a bit divided that, you know, is it a rip-off that we've got to go and see the final story in two installments? They did it with Twilight, did it with Harry Potter. I love going to the movies to see films like this, so I don't mind. I'll be back there in a year.
And second last chance to see Philip Seymour Hoffman too.
Yeah, exactly right. I mean, the film's dedicated to him. 4 stars for The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1. Can't wait to see the second one.
Next movie sounds really interesting. Mm.
This is brilliant. Thanks so much also for your love for The Mule yesterday. That's top 20 on iTunes already.
Oh, terrific.
Really exciting. Well, this is another...
By the way.
Thank you. This is another local film from Across the Ditch, starring one of the guys from Once Were Warriors and the star of Boy. This is The Dark Horse. It's winning praise worldwide. It is already one of the top 10 grossing New Zealand films. Let's take...
Of all time. Whoa.
And it's about a man spreading positivity, helping wayward kids. Let's take a look.
As members of Easter Knights, you belong to a very special whānau, which means... You will each be represented by a warrior on this board. You have to keep it with you at all times. As a kaitiaki, or guardian, a practice, you return it here, back to the board, to reunite us all as a family. Okay?
Yep.
Line up then.
Cliff Curtis is amazing as Genesis Patini, who is a real guy, a Gisborne Speed chess champion who passed away a couple of years ago. 4 stars for The Dark Horse. The kids in this film are astonishing. As I say, you know, if you love Once Were Warriors and Boy, beautiful film, go check it out.
Terrific. They do make good films, Curtis, don't
they?
Damn
straight.
Yeah.
I don't know if they really talk like that, though, but...
Which, have you ever played chess in New Zealand?
No.
They do. Thanks, Jabba.
Thanks, guys. Cheers.